What's up, everyone, and welcome to another Rust Electrical tutorial. I'm Austin, and today we're going to be talking about Simple Base Lockdown version 3. Before we do that, I just want to throw a big thank you out there. I crested over 3K subs here recently, and you're all amazing, and I just want you to know that without you, this would not have been possible. So we'll use this fun little admin mod to throw up some fireworks. But 3K subscribers, that is a huge number for me. This has been a long kind of slow growth journey for me, and I've had a great time doing it, and you are all amazing. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started. This is, again, like I said, Simple Base Lockdown version 3. It is not so much an improvement over version 2 as much as it is just kind of an easier way to do about the same idea. This came about because, and you know, we gotta give credit where credit's due. I got a great comment from Elmo Tricks on the version 2 video. And he said, if you daisy chain them and one controller gets destroyed, the others would instantly lose power and close on their own anyway. And that is absolutely correct. And if you'll recall from any of my other base lockdown videos, I keep telling everyone, you know, don't daisy chain. You're gonna wanna run individual lines. It's safer, because if you lose one, you only lose it. But this is a great point, and something I never thought about is that the idea of daisy chaining these actually makes them more secure, because anyone that loses power is gonna automatically close. That's how these systems work. So we're gonna use this idea, this great idea, to come up with this base lockdown version 3. And so I'm just gonna give you a quick tour of it, and then we're gonna demo this just so you can see how it works. I have 8 doors set up here. All of them have door controllers on them, and unlike my other ones, these are daisy chains. One's powering the next one and so forth. It just goes down the line. And in here behind this twig, I have a shotgun trap. And so the idea being here is that you have a switch on here. I'm using a branch because there's multiple down circuit, but if it's a single one, you'd probably just, you know, a blocker or this would work. It doesn't really matter what switch you use as long as it passes power. In this case, with this many doors, a branch makes sense. So I've got a branch here. I have it set to 8 because I have 8 doors, 8 door controllers. The main power is, of course, coming from this power bank, and I've got 9 running out, 1 to account for that switch. There we go, we have 8. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to de-off myself from this TC, and then I'm going to make myself visible. There we go. And I'm gonna pass in front of this. And what you'll notice, actually, before we do that, let me just open a couple doors just so that you can see the way this is gonna work. I've got some doors open, and right now, you know, the system is already powered, right? So they're all ready to go. So if I make myself visible here, and I were to be a raider and I pass in front of this, there we go. It starts to fire at me. I'll make myself invisible. And now all the doors have shut because we lost power. All we did was eliminate the power source to these controllers, and we're good to go. And so to arm that, all you would do, let me just get back into here. To arm this, you would simply build another twig. There we go. So I would arm that. I would simply grab, you know, put yourself another branch switch on there in this case. Put this wherever. I'm going to set this to 8 for the doors. And then I'm gonna run a line down from here and run that over to this branch over here, like so. And then run the output of that out and up to our door controller. So now when it's armed, you can see that it opens everything. This is the same way that version 2 works. If you've seen that video, of course, I'll link those for you. But it's the same way, is that the way these systems arm is that you power the doors and then you shut them. And the idea is that you're running around your base. You've got some doors open, some doors closed. And then I'll just break this for the shotgun trap. But if this is broken, you can see that all the doors that are open are closed, and the ones that are closed are not affected. So that is pretty cool. This is a much easier way to do it. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're going to go ahead and work on the build. You're just gonna have to have some power source. And right here, you know, like I just showed you, I put a branch on there, so we'll do that again. But I'll show you what you can do is, if you assume that you have some power source, all you have to do is whatever the power source is, it's gonna be before the start of the daisy chain, right? So you'll daisy chain all your controllers together, however many that is, and then you'll just send that amount of power down there. But what you can do is, let's say I wanted to have multiple, you know, this is like a mock input, right, going to your base. So you have some kind of input where the entryway or where you think the raiders are gonna go, and they're gonna come in through here, and they're gonna get detected by that that shotgun trap, and it's going to blast this and break that and close any open doors you got. So what you can do if you're trying to do multiple, and we'll go over those over there, you can also just have, let me grab another branch. There we go. You can have as many of these as you want, and all you have to do at this point, I usually change to blockers, actually, and I'll show you that later. And the only reason I like blockers is that they're actually earlier in the tech tree, but also they don't have the minimum two units of power coming out of the branch out requirement. It's not a big deal in a lot of cases, but if you're trying to just simply do this, you know, you might consider doing it this way. It's up to you. But I'm gonna just go ahead and run this out, and then we'll just count up what we need from our power source here. And we'll just pop that into there. There we go. And so this is gonna open everything but that last one. And the reason that is because I have two switches in here. So that's eight doors. So that's 8 rust watts I need. 9 rust watts, 10 rust watts this time because I have two switches this time. So I'm gonna go ahead and just change this to 10, and you'll notice that our other one opens. And so now once this is armed, and this is how you would arm it. You send power to your doors, you're done, it's armed. Now you open and close them, you run around your base, you do whatever you're doing. It doesn't matter, whatever it is you're doing. Let's say that's what it is right there. And then let's say somebody breaks into wherever this panel is. And what the idea here is that these twigs will be somewhere, whether either if you use a shotgun trap or you just put them in a place where the raider is forced to break them, meaning either during the course of the raid or it just simply is in their way and they must break it. And you know, no rust player is not going to break a piece of twigs. So this is a very easy way to do this. Let's say they came in through this one. It doesn't matter which one breaks. It is going to cycle all these doors down anyway. And that's it. The build is very simple. You just need the door controllers, and you need a way to break the power source. In this case, I'm using Twig. And so that's the big difference. So before we do some examples, I'm just gonna show you the difference between the other two over here. The base lockdown one, if you remember this one, once it's armed, if it's armed and then it triggers, it's gonna open any closed doors and then shut them. I'll link that video. And this works fine because the idea was is that it would, at least no matter what, it looks like I need to probably have some, there we go. If you had open doors and it was armed and it got triggered, it's gonna close them, but it's gonna cycle the closed ones. And then in the beginning, that was just sort of something that I lived with, but I didn't like it. Version two was you know, a huge improvement where once it's armed, the way it's armed, much like this, is that it actually sends power to the door controller. If it's closed, and I'll make myself visible here, it triggered, but it didn't do anything based on how, right, based on the properties that we talked about. So the opposite being that if it was open and it was armed, just like this, and then it triggered, it's gonna close it, but it's not gonna cycle anything. So that was obviously a huge improvement. This is the same thing. Base Lockdown 3 is really no different than Base Lockdown 2. It simply just omits all of this stuff here. So if you're trying not to use you know, HPHF sensors, timers, whatever. This is really, really simple. It's just any switch at all that passes. It just has to pass. So if you had a splitter, it doesn't matter what it is. You can use anything that passes power. That's kind of it. It could be lights. It could be anything that passes power. And so once it's armed, we'll just pop this back up there. You know, once it's armed, it's a little bit overcharged. That's okay. You know, it doesn't matter what's open or closed because of the way they work. You'll see that they all have double green lights. You know, once that panel is broken, there you go. So for some of you, I think this might actually just be the easiest way to do this. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to look at just three sort of examples of how you can manipulate that twig. And then the first one here, you know, I've got a door that's already armed. It's already been powered up. And the switch, you know, this could be a blocker. Any switch that passes power, like I said, it does not matter. It just needs to pass one unit of power. If it's a single, you know, a single thing, it's just one unit per door controller, I guess I should say. And so the idea being that this is somewhere in your base, and if a raider comes in, they are literally forced to break it, and it's gonna close anything attached to it. So simple as that. This next one is, if you were to, you know, let's say they busted in this front door. This one's got a shotgun trap on it. So up here, I've got a shotgun trap aimed down. So it's a twig idea. I've got a blocker hooked up this time. If I were to de-off myself from this, and come back in here, make myself visible. If this is, wait, let me open that door. Assuming this door is open, this goes to your base somewhere or whatever. Let's say they break in, they bust this door, you know, pretend this door was actually just to, I'll make myself visible. There we go. This door was destroyed, and as they come in, they get shot by this. It's gonna shut that door because it broke the twig that had the switch on it. So very, very simple. And then the last idea is the same idea, except that in this one, let's say this is the door into the base, is that I've wired these up to the walls this time. So let's say you have a base where you're worried about people coming through the walls, or you wanna be a little more thorough about what it covers and what's triggered. So let's say they raid in from, you know, this side here, the door is open. It doesn't matter which wall is broken because it breaks the power chain, because the last piece of any of these circuits is always gonna be the door controller, so it shuts the door. So it doesn't matter which one they use. So that's pretty much that. All right, so the last thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you just these ideas installed on a very, very simple 2x2. In this case, I've actually hidden the door controllers in a way that I'm curious if anyone knows how I've done this, but there are door controllers in here. They are hidden. And I'm about to release a door controller video that covers all this, including how to hide them this way. So to kind of, you know, clear up some comments and things I get a lot about door controllers. But I've set this up with door controllers on all the doors. You can see that one back here for this one. The other one, two, three are hidden. And I've wired in those on every wall. So in here, I've got this, the same idea I just showed you. This is a mix. I've got one where I've got a blocker on a twig, and I've got a shotgun trap up in here, aimed down through the door. So if someone were to door raid, they'd come through and break that blocker. That's gonna shut all the doors. Or if they choose, if someone comes through and breaks through any of these walls, if they were to raid through for some reason and chose to come in from the side, there's a switch on every single exterior wall, and this would cover them raid walling. And you could also, assuming there were ceilings in here, if you had a ceiling in here, you could put one on the ceiling as well, and just literally encapsulate yourself so that, you know, I think at this point you're talking about maybe a bigger base, but the point is, I'll show you here, we have this base. Let's say the doors are open, maybe you're doing something and somebody onlines you, they break through these doors. And as soon as they, I make myself visible here, come in here, this is gonna fire. And you can see that it's gonna close, and presumably I was, you know, probably killed doing that. So that's, you know, and again, had I broken in through an exterior wall, it would have done the exact same thing and closed. So that, folks, is just about all I've got. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. Otherwise, you can get me on my Discord. See you later.